They were both silent for a little while. Then Captain Jim said very softly, "Mistress Blythe, may I tell you about lost Margaret?"
"Of course," said Anne gently.
She did not know who lost Margaret was, but she felt that she was going to hear the romance of Captain Jim's life.
"I've often wanted to tell you about her," Captain Jim went on. "Do you know why, Mistress Blythe? It's because I want somebody to remember and think of her sometimes after I'm gone. I can't bear that her name should be forgotten by all living souls, and now nobody remembers lost Margaret but me."
Then Captain Jim told the story, an old, old, forgotten story, for it was over 50 years since Margaret had fallen asleep one day in her father's dory and drifted, or so it was supposed, for nothing was ever certainly known as to her fate, out to the channel beyond the bar, to perish in the black thunder squall which had come up so suddenly that long ago summer afternoon. But to Captain Jim those 50 years were but as yesterday when it is past.
"I walked the shore for months after that," he said sadly, "looking to find her dear, sweet little body, but the sea never gave her back to me. But I'll find her sometime, Mistress Blythe. I'll find her sometime. She's waiting for me. I wish I could tell you just how she looked, but I can't. I've seen a fine silvery mist hanging over the bar at sunrise that seemed like her, and then again I've seen a white birch in the woods back yonder that made me think of her. She had pale brown hair, and a little white, sweet face, and long, slender fingers like yours, Mistress Blythe, only browner, for she was a shore girl. Sometimes I wake up in the night and hear the sea calling to me in the old way, and it seems as if lost Margaret called in it. And when there's a storm and the waves are sobbing and moaning, I hear her lamenting among them. And when they laugh on a gay day, it's her laugh, lost Margaret's sweet, roguish little laugh.